Yeah, buddy.
Thank you po.
All right. So let me show to you first our first outline, but at least we could have a quick orientation on what we will be discussing all throughout this set of sessions. So let me quickly share my screen. San ba yan? Ay, ito pala. Share screen. And okay, so can you see this screen right now? Okay, so I decided since we are looking forward in studying pure mathematics, so this will be in the context of four areas of mathematics. We will start with group theory. So we are going to discuss about symmetries on how it is being treated theoretically in mathematics with its applications later, particularly in physics and some other aspects of mathematics. Normally kasi, if you will be studying classical mechanics and quantum mechanics or any other mechanics, like statistical mechanics, there's a recurring discussion about group theory. So it's one thing that we will be looking at. The second one, to prepare you on some languages for the probability theory, let's quickly discuss about real analysis. And this will be followed by probability theory, and then finally, some theory on linear algebra. So as from our discussion last time, kung naalala ko, you have some background now of linear algebra, particularly with matrix analysis, tama ba?
Tama.
Ayun. So for this, all of the sessions, ang target ko sana for each session, isang outline matatapos natin. For now, for example, I'm targeting, discussion natin will be on groups and subgroups. And then the other meeting naman, we will talk about cyclic and permutation groups. So ganun ang magiging series of discussion natin. So parang all in all, I am looking forward to discuss around within 21 sessions with you under this topic. So yun yung target sana natin. Maybe if it would really take some much time later, although I have prepared around 2 hours of discussion, maybe it might take longer. Just let me know kung may mga appointments ka right after. Ako personally, if I have some appointments right after, I'll just tell you na we will cut the time short. So for now, I'm looking forward mga around 2 hours for today. So we will end by around 7. So I have already given you all of these resources. So I hope medyo na umpisan mo na basa, but we will just discuss some of the examples later on this. So that will be okay kung merong advanced reading o walang advanced reading. That will be fine. But at the end of each topic, I have prepared assignments for you to try to compute for the next meeting. I'll be asking you to discuss it. So hopefully may mga ganun tayong interactions later. Okay. All right. So for Joshua, do you have any questions or clarifications before we formally start?
Wala naman po.
All right. So let me again share my screen with you on the other side. Okay. By the way, I'll be sharing this some of the PDF copy of my lectures with you. So let's start share.
Thank you po.
Para at least may copies ka rin later.
Thank you very much po. Excited po kami. Kasi sabi nyo, yung mga, yan nyo rin yung mga the wise, di ba po, of the things. Kasi usually,
oh, yeah.
mga na-experience, not all, pero mostly, hindi ba they just teach you how to compute eh, parang rote learning, di ba po? So, pero sabi ko, mas maganda yun, talaga, yun, why, and ano ba yung mga, po, tsaka applications.
Okay, titignan po natin because I still don't know yung background ni Joshua. Okay. I'll be adjusting naman kung how fast or how slow I'm going to be in this discussion. Just let me know, Joshua, if there are things that you want to understand. Okay? So let's start with defining what a group is. So normally, when you're talking about a group, it's we can represent this in terms of a set. So let's consider a set G. So I think this is a set is not, it's not new to you. It's just a collection of objects, things, numbers, etc. So let's consider this set to be G, and let's define what you call a structure, particularly a binary operation. For example, you can think of this as the collection of numbers, and then maglalagay ka ng isang structure dun. When we're talking about structure, an operation. Addition, multiplication, subtraction, division is an example of an operation or a, what you call a binary operation. So let's define what you call a binary operation. So medyo bit slower lang ako sa pagsusulat. Just bear with me. So let's define a binary operation as follows. So a binary operation can be defined as a function. Anong klaseng function are we talking about? This is a function given a pair of sets. So in this case, G cross G or G times G, and it's mapped to a set G such that if you take an ordered pair of any of these two, any of these elements, dapat ang resulting action of this operation must be in G as well. So in other words, in this case, if I have G sub 1, G sub 2, yung product ng G sub 1, G sub 2 corresponds to an element in G. So I'll just use the term, gagamit ako ng term, either ways, pwede ko siya pagbaliktarin. I might be using the term for this asterisk to be product, or sometimes magsiswitch ako, I'll be saying this as addition. But the terms product and addition may not necessarily be the usual product or addition that you have encountered in regular arithmetic. So medyo, once in a while kasi mag-emphasize ako if I'll say ordinary product or ordinary addition, it's the usual addition or product you have encountered. But kung may mga special na mga symbols tayo na gagamitin or operations, I'll just emphasize it to you. Okay? So, for now, I'll be using this asterisk, but sometimes, wala na siyang asterisk to indicate na ideally merong operation in between. Okay? So, let's consider yung mga basic examples na so far we are familiar with. So, an example of this binary operation are as follows. Ang alam natin, so far, the addition. So, this is a binary operation between R cross R, and dapat ang output niya is also the set of real numbers. So, if you have noticed na any sum of elements of a real number will always result to a real number. So, do you agree ba, Joshua?
Apo.
Ayan. So, that's it for now. So, clear tayo dyan. So, any real number, say, I'll just get, say, A and B. So, ang sum ng dalawang ito must be also a real number. So, no question about it. How about subtraction? Is this a binary operation? So, meaning, if we take... By the way, sometimes I'll be using R cross R, or sometimes I'll be using R squared. So, they have the same meaning lang naman yan. So, in this case, susulat ko dito ngayon na R squared maps to R. So, the question... If I'll take an ordered pair, A and B, is the outcome A minus B also a real number?
I think so, mo.
Yes. So, tama. It's also a real number pa rin. How about, let's consider, oh, mag-change tayo, hindi na ngayon real number. And at this time, I'll be using multiplication, the usual multiplication. But this multiplication... is subject to some operation. So, an operation natin will be of this form. Ang usual na multiplication. Take two integers, A and B. Take the product, the usual product, or the ordinary product. The question, the product of two integers ba is an integer?
Yes.
Yes. So, any number na basta integer, if you take the product, it will always be an integer. Okay. How about the other one? Parang okay na, tatlo. We have shown, itong mga examples na to are, these are binary operations. How about this one? Subtraction tayo ulit, pero this time, with the set of integers pa rin. So the question, if I'll take any integer A and B, and I'll take the difference between these two numbers, the question, is this an integer as well?
Abo.
Ayun. So no problem. So all of these are examples of binary operations. But let's consider this set. How about if you have the set of natural numbers? So the question is, if you consider difference pa rin, if I'll take A and B, is the difference always a natural number?
Not always, but could be a negative.
Can you give an example? Negative. So, halimbawa, again, Joshua?
3 minus 4 ball.
So, 3 minus 4. If, for example, if A is equal to 3 and B is equal to 4, so therefore, A minus B is equal to negative 1. So, therefore, this is not the set of natural number. So, in other words, we're saying, now for this example, this is not a binary operation. So as long as you have an example or a counterexample that negates the definition, so therefore, in this case, for a binary operation, so hindi siya binary operation. So some trivia lang, I think, with these sets. I don't know if familiar ka na to. The set of integers. So we know this is just a set of whole numbers, positive, negative, with zero. So normally, they use the symbol Z. Kung I don't know kung nabasa mo yung text na kalagay din doon eh. Do you know why it's called Z?
German for number.
Ayan. So the word is, I think, Zahle, no? For the word number. Okay. That's correct. Ayan. Second, how about the set of natural numbers? Ano ba yung composition nito? Ng set of natural numbers?
Non-negative integers minus zero pa ba?
Ayan. So, in some books, may mga books kasi, when you're talking about the set of natural numbers, it always starts with 1, which are positive integers. So therefore, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Pero in some books, take note, for example, if you're dealing with analysis, some of the natural numbers starts with 0. So depende sa libro na gagamitin mo. So take note lang na may mga books kasi na they would include zero into the set of natural numbers. May mga libro na rin na that would strictly follow pa rin na it starts with 1 for the set of natural numbers. So in this case, sa ating case, I think gagamitin lang natin the set of natural numbers to be starts with 1. Pero I'll use the special symbol N sub 0 to indicate this is the set of natural numbers together with 0. So yun lang ang magiging some of the notations that we will going to have. Okay? So now, I think we are now ready to define what is a group. And these are the definition or the outline of what a group is. So let me go back to my color. Let the black. So, what is a group?
Ang ganda po ng handwriting niya for a mathematician.
Actually, sometimes kung nagmamadali ko, pumapangit to eh. So, when you're defining a group is still a set. So, in this case, let's use the set G together with a binary operation. So, I'll just use the asterisk definition. If and only if, together with the following ingredients. Naalala mo pa yung mga ingredients sa, so far sa initial readings mo?
Yung ano mo?
Ng definition ng group.
I'm pretty sure yan lang po yung tagan. It needs to have a binary operation in the set, yung parent set na mo.
Yes, oo. Together with, may dugtong pa to. So for this to be group, maliban sa pagiging binary operation, by the way, when you're talking about a binary operation, so you're also defining closure. So let me emphasize it here. So ang ibig sabihin din dito ng binary operation is that you're talking about your operation star is close under, baliktad ang pagkakastate ko. The chi is close, baliktad. Star is close under G. So meaning to say, you're talking about closure. So any operation between two elements, it must be an element of that same set. So yun lang naman ang ibig sabihin ng binary operation. So dadagdag natin. So may tatlong kailangan tayong ingredients for this to be a group. The first one is the concept of associativity. So meaning to say, when you're talking about associativity, is that if you have three elements, so let's call this A, B, and C, and you take the product or addition or subtraction again later, and then kung uunahin mo and B, A and B together, then the third element, you will have the same result as A times B times C. So in your basic calculation sa elementary, I think there's an emphasis on this. Pero baka mag-iisip ka bakit may re-emphasis naman ngayon. Kasi some of the binary operations may not necessarily be associative. So in this case, sa ating gagamitin is that your binary operation must be associative this way. Okay? The second ingredient na kailangan mo for this to be a set, kailangan mo meron kang identity element. Okay, what do we mean an identity element? There must exist, by the way, familiar ka naman sa mga mathematical symbol, no? Like in this case, an inverted E to be, there exists?
Abo.
Okay, good. So there exists an element of G, let's call it letter E. This will be our identity element. Such for every A in G, such that if you multiply your E with A or vice versa, pwedeng E times A. So from the term identity, magiging A pa rin siya. So can you remember from the usual collection of numbers you have? Can you give me an example of an identity element for a particular operation or binary operation?
For addition, it is 0, and for multiplication,
okay,
1 po siya for multiplication.
Correct. So that's the concept. So for the identity element, so basta any number, if you perform the operation, must be equal to that number na minumultiplyan mo ng identity element. So in this case, you have 0 and 1 respectively for addition and multiplication. And lastly, meron dapat you need to satisfy the last one.
Medyo ano po, sabi po. Sabi po kaya.
Inverse elements. Okay. Okay. Let me know kung medyo nagchachapi ako once in a while. Eh. So mag-slow down lang.
That's okay na po.
Okay. Ayun na. Medyo okay na ba?
Okay. Medyo okay na po.
Okay na po.
Ito ako sa bahay. Sometimes I'm just using my date. So it's a bit a bit crazy sometimes. Okay. So inverse element. Ito. Let's define an inverse element. So, mapapansin nyo, babaliktad ang magiging symbols na gagamitin ko. For every A in G, there exists, let's call this B in G, such that if I'll multiply A times B or B times A, it must be the identity element. So, tingnan mong expression na ginamit natin dito. For every G, so meaning sa lahat-lahat daw ng element mo sa G, so in this case A, there will exist a B. So meaning you will always have a pairing. So for each of the A, may pair ka daw na B together. If you take the product, it must be E. So halimbawa, earlier from your example under addition and multiplication, can you give me examples of inverses of elements?
Yung inverse nung in addition po, inverse is the negation. So yung like 5, may negative 5 po yung ka-pair niya to
correct.
And then for multiplication, it's the reciprocal.
Okay, correct. So ang binigay mo na example, particular element to. So try to imagine na this is strictly we're utilizing na all elements of G. So, in other words, for this to be satisfied, ito yung pinaka-stricto na part ng definition ng group that you have to satisfy that each of the element will have an inverse. So, if you have an example of 5 with negative 5 or 5 with 1 over 5 under multiplication, how about the other numbers? So, yun ang magiging basis natin later as we have some examples to show to you. So particularly, so ito na, as long as you satisfy all of these, having a binary operation, associativity of the binary operation, existence of an identity element for all elements of G, and for each of the elements of G, meron kang inverse, all of these, if satisfied, so you will have a group. So now, ang wala dito na emphasize from these properties, it's actually commutativity. Wala tayong may sinabi about a commutative operation. So let's consider if what if you have a commutative operation. So let star be a commutative binary operation. Say, for example, in this case, so commutative, so meaning pwede siya mag-reverse. So if you have A times B, it's just the same as doing B times A. So therefore, if you satisfy this under a group, your group is called the
abelian,
correct? Okay. Called an abelian group. Okay. From the mathematician Niels Abel. Okay. Ayun. So let's have some examples para at least you get all of these concepts. Okay. Examples. So just let me know kung if it's a group or not a group. The first one. Ang syempre, yung pinakauna, pinaka-familiar tayo. Real numbers together with their usual addition. Is this a group?
Yes. Associative. May identity. Meron din siyang inverse. Yes po.
Yes. So, anong identity dito?
Identity is zero and inverse is its negative.
Yes, correct. So, this is a group. How about the set of integers under addition?
No, kasi may ano po, yung, wait. Tama ba? Yes. Kasi meron po siyang inverse pa rin.
Yes. Actually, medyo careful tayo is looking at the inverse, di ba? Unlike kasi sa identity, it's easy to spot kagad. It's zero. Associativity, automatic siya. Basta ordinary lang to na addition. Ano pa ba? Associativity, yes. It follows and so on. So, correct. How about this one? At pangatlo. Ito, the set of natural numbers under addition.
Does not always have an inverse. Actually, it does not have any inverse. Because there's
correct. So, wala siyang no additive inverse. Particularly, and you can always cite an example. Say, if you have 5, anong dapat additive inverse nito?
Negative 5, which is not in natural numbers.
Correct. So, yun. So, therefore, this is not a group. Next, ito naman. How about the set of real numbers under multiplication? Is this a group?
Yes, po.
What if I'll tell you no?
Zero.
Can you identify?
Zero.
Yes, zero. So therefore, this is not a group, pero we can rewrite this. What if we let R star be the collection of R, pero we are to remove zero? Remove that in zero. By the way, may mga notation tayong gagamitin for like subtraction or set difference. So in some texts, gumagamit sila ng ganito. Ay, sulat ko dito. Sorry, medyo masilaw ko ngayon sa ano, sa inuupuan ko.
Obo.
Okay. In some texts, diretsong set difference, nagma-minus ka lang ng zero. But in more often sa mga texts na to, gumagamit sila ng ganito. So either use this, pabaliktad na slash o backslash, or we use this. Okay. So you might say, so anong difference ng slash at backslash? Normally kasi later when we are to talk about factor groups, ito yung slash ang gagamitin natin just to avoid the confusion for set difference and factor groups. So for now, ito lang munang gagamitin ko for the set difference. Sorry, re-remove mo yung zero. So in this case, kung mare-remove mo ng zero, so therefore, you can right away say na under multiplication, this is a group. Okay? So in other words, kanina, initially, nagka-problema ka in identifying kasi almost lahat, actually, lahat-lahat sila almost merong multiplicative inverse. Except for one number lang alone. So therefore, that's zero as you have identified it. Kasi if you look back again the definition ng inverse, it must satisfy the expression for all. Lahat-lahat talaga. Alright? So is this clear for you?
Okay.
That's good. Okay. Alam mo, natutuwa ako kasi ang bilis mong mag-isip. Okay. So now next. Ito naman. How about, ito na, set of integers under ordinary multiplication?
Hindi po kasi wala na yung mga fractions. Wala na mga
correct
fractional numbers.
Katulad kanina, sa set of real numbers, I just simply remove zero for it to be a group. Dito ba pwede natin gawin?
Hindi po kasi almost all din may ano po, except one.
Okay, except one. So the only number na may multiplicative inverse is only one and the rest wala talaga. So therefore, this is, okay, not a group. Okay, next. Tadaya. So isa-isa natin. How about the set of rational numbers under, say, multiplication? Addition muna.
Addition. Yes. Yes, ma. Yes, yes, mo.
Yes. Okay, correct. So that's yes. How about under multiplication?
I think yes po, kasi kasama na po lahat ng mga fractions, mga reciprocals.
And I'll tell you what if wrong. Hindi.
Alam ko na po, nalilito po ko na I keep forgetting zero. So,
yes.
hindi po talaga kasama siya lagi. So, magkasama po.
Yun.
Never.
So, again, same pa rin ginawa natin. So, you let Q star remove that. Itong usual na ginagamit na symbol, removal of an element, naglalagay lang sila ng parang star dyan. But isang book sometimes umiiba din. So, depende sa binabasa mong books. So, this time, by removing the zero, so automatic, magiging group na siya. Ayan. So, take note. Sometimes kasi nakaka-ano yung maliliit na kahit isa lang yun eh. Okay, ito. Next question. How about the set of, dito na ako, i-align ko na lang pala. Ay, iba pala. Para si ibahin ko na lang. How about the set of irrational numbers under, say, addition?
Irrational. Meron po siyang associativity, meron din siyang inverse. Meron ba siyang na? Yes. Opo.
So kung isa-isahin mo, is the sum of two irrational numbers still an irrational number?
I think so mo.
Yes. So associative, yes, automatic, kasi ordinary addition lang to. Identity, is the identity an irrational number?
Oh no. Okay.
Yeah.
Zero po.
Ayon. So therefore, this is not a group since one under addition, di ba? Sorry, sir. Under addition, di ba? So therefore, anong identity?
Identity is
zero.
So ano mo?
Siya yon. So medyo careful ka. Isa-isahin natin yung definition. So hindi. So therefore, that's the only number actually nagka-problema. Inverses lahat eh. So negative lang of the irrational number. So now next, ano naman? Ano pa yung isang mga example? Oh, multiplication. Ayan. Ayan. Multiplication.
Now, this time po, zero is automatically excluded because it's not an irrational number. Lahat ba sila? One over an irrational number is not an irrational number. No?
Yes.
I think so po. So, yung associative din, okay, sure.
Yes.
And then the identity is one. Oh, the identity is one. So, hindi po, no. Not a group.
Ayan. Hindi. Okay. May actually, may dalawang reason. So, you identified one. One is not irrational. So, hindi pwedeng magiging identity si one. May isa pa na nag-violate siya sa definition of a group. Okay. Sa associative, okay yung inverse. So, ang one hindi pwede. May isa pa.
One is not the identity. Ano pa? Zero is not.
Hint. Binary operation. Is multiplication the binary operation for this?
So kung any irrational number times an irrational number.
Is it an irrational number always?
No, kasi for me, ano ba? Mas square root of 2?
Yan, square root of 2. So, alibawa, square root of 2 times square root of 2, both of these are irrational numbers, pero ang product nila, it's 2, which is not an irrational number. So, yun. So, hindi niya na-satisfy. So, in this case, may dalawang criteria na hindi niya na-satisfy. So, therefore, this is not a group. Okay, so ito na, next. Another example. How about the set of even numbers? Even? Na integers? Under addition?
So, the binary operation, just to be sure na lang mo. Lahat,
mm-mm.
Okay.
Okay.
Associativity, and then identity is zero. Okay, so the inverse, meron din. Yes po.
Yes. Okay. So as to closure, we know, how do we usually express an even number ba?
2 times n mo, where n is an
even. So any number twice of an even number is always twice of an integer. So if you add any of these, it's always twice of an any integer. So therefore, it satisfies closure, associativity as always, identity. It is zero, it's an even number, and the inverses are simply additive inverse, negative lang of an even number. So therefore, you're correct. Okay. How about this set of add tayo? Under addition.
The identity zero is not an add number, so therefore
it's
not.
Yeah. So zero is not an element of odd. May isa pa, hindi na-violate niya.
Binary operation.
Yes. Bakit? Bakit ang binary operation?
Ano po yung pag any odd number plus another odd number, it's even.
Ayun, correct. So for example, in the case 2n plus 1 and 2n plus 1, these are actually odd numbers. And add them together. So in this case, 2m plus 1 plus 2n plus 1. So the sum is what? 4n, 4, sorry, 4n, 2mn, or susulat na lang natin 2 times m plus n plus 2, or you can rewrite this as 2 times m plus n plus 1. But this is an integer. It's twice an integer, so this makes to be an even number. So any odd numbers sum together, it's always an even number. I mean, odd numbers add together is an even number. So we are correct. Hindi. All right. So now next, medyo update tayo ng a bit high order na mga set of integers. At this time, magde-define ako ng isang set of integer. Let's call this z sub n. I think na-encounter mo yan sa readings mo. In some books, ito yung pagkakasulat nila. In some books, either isusulat nila ito ganito. Paganyan. So gagamitin ko muna yung first symbol kasi when we consider discussing about factor groups, maintindihan mo na to kung bakit ito ginagamit the same as the earlier one. So delete ko lang to muna. Okay. So let's define this first as the collection of 0, 1, 2, until n minus 1. So in this case, the cardinality of this group or the number of elements of this group, there are n of them, starts with 0 hanggang n minus 1. And we define what you call an operation plus na may sub n. So it's defined as follows. I-define natin. Let me see. I-define ko na lang siya as ayun. As a binary operation. So if you take, say, A and B, and then if you add these together, under this operation, it must belong to Z sub n as long as you take the modulo of that number n. Have you encountered naman yung modulo na? Tama?
Remainder of the
remaining. Yes. So you're correct. It's just the remainder by dividing it by n. So yon. So now, okay, ito na. Meron ka ng bagong operation. So the question is this a group? So let's have some examples para at least maintindihan natin. Say for example, consider ang pinakamadali, I believe it's when n is equal to 2 muna, para at least maliit lang. When n is equal to 2, so therefore, z sub n, or z sub 2, it is composed of only 2 elements, 0 and 1, and let's use the operation under modulo 2. Okay? So, ang pinakamabilis actually to evaluate these types of numbers, gumagawa tayo ng parang addition table or multiplication table, or in general, we will be calling this the Cayley table.
Cayley
table. So, ayan. Cayley table. So, ang gagawin lang natin, so, gagawa tayo parang addition table. So, under addition, sub 2, this is 0, this is 1, this is 0, and this 1. So, obviously, if you take the sum of each of the elements across all of these, so you will have the following. So, this will be 0, this is 1, obviously, kasi yan ang ating identity element. So, you have 0 and 1. So, what is 1 plus 1 in this 2. Case?
So, 2 modulo
but 2. But under modulo 2?
0 po.
0. Okay. So, can we now evaluate in terms of closure? Is this addition close under Z2?
Zero. So, ano po natagal? Dapat 0 plus 1. Ano rin? Element siya. So, kung sila, lahat sa table po, element naman ng Z2.
Correct. So, correct. So, therefore, lahat lang ng mga sabi mo, lahat ng mga elements sa table na to are in Z2. So, therefore, it satisfies ng Z2 under this addition is close. Okay, satisfying closure. How about associativity? Masasatisfy niya ba? Although, konting element pa lang to eh. Pero, try to imagine, can this new addition, hindi na to ordinary addition, but under a modulo, can still be satisfied?
0 and 0 plus 1, okay. 0, 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 1. 1, 2, 3. Okay. 0, 1, 1. Tama. 1, 1. Okay. Tama po.
Yes, it satisfies. By the way, may mali lang ako sa pagkakasulat dito. Let me rewrite this. Ito. I-rewrite ko to. Erase ko to modulo n. Kasi yung pagkaka-define dito dapat, I'll be writing this. This is equal to, let's see, erase ko muna to. This is equal to the ordinary a plus b under modulo n. So, dapat yan ang magiging simple natin. Kasi, bakit ko sinulat this way? Kasi this one, yung addition natin dito, this is just your ordinary addition. Ordinary. So, kung ordinary addition to, so you're talking about associativity would still follow. So, in other words, pwede mong mapuprove later that if you take, gagawin ko tong red, ah, kung if you take A plus B first under modulo N, together with the third one, you can show under the said modulo, magiging pareho din siya by taking B and C first under modulo N, tapos sunod yung A. Let me delete pala to. All right. Ayun. So you can always show that. Magagawa mo ito. So I'll just leave this to you later for the proving. I-develop natin yung skill sets natin every time when we do the proving. Okay. So n is equal to 2 ito. Para let's make this bigger, hanggang 5. So how about when n is equal to 3? Asan na yan? Ito pala. Okay. So n is equal to 3. So again, you're talking about Z3 and modulo 3. So may tatlo ka na. Let me write here. So 0, 1, and 2. 0, 1, and 2. So can you help me fill the table, first row?
0, tapos 1, tapos 2. Obo,
okay. First, second row.
Second row. 1, 2. Tapos, pagkatapos, 0 na po ulit.
Alright, correct. And then finally,
2.
The last row. Okay.
0, 1. 1.
Okay. So actually, makikita mo ng pattern dito as we make it bigger. Mas madali na siya makikita. So, as you can see on the table,
diagonal po. Obo.
Ayan, pa-diagonal. Parang nag-ano lang siya, nag-rotate yung number. So, nag-move lang siya pabaliktad yung rotation niya. So, as you move later, gawin na lang natin sa 4 para at least isang observation na lang. Okay, sa 4 tayo. Z4 under addition. So, ito under 3. And then ngayon, gawin natin 1, 2, 3. Gawin natin 4. Plus 4 dito. 0, 1, 2, and 3. Okay. 1, 2, sorry, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, and 3. So, meron tayong ganito. So, anong mga elements nito? First row muna.
0, 1, 2, 3 po.
Ayan, 0, 1, 2, 3. Second row?
1, 2, 3, 0.
1, 2, 3, 0. Third row?
3, 0, 1.
2, 3, 0, 1, and then finally
0, 1, 2.
So you will have 3, 0, 1, and 2. Okay. So now, so kuha mo ng pattern, magiging itsura, but try to look at this. Were you able to see that there's closure property or the binary operation works? Now,
Labo.
Any element added together, it must be found on the same set.
Labo.
Yes. So therefore, the closure is satisfied. But we want to identify muna. Gusto natin identify. Ano ang magiging identity element nyo dito? Anong identity element for each of these example?
So when we add any element to that identity, it should return the same thing.
Okay, so therefore, what's the identity element?
Looks like 0 pa rin. 3 plus 0.
Yes.
0 pa na po.
So, identity element. Identity element in Zn is still 0 for all n. So, greater than or equal to, sa tayo, umpisa 2, di ba? So, kasi, later, trivial na ang 0 lang alone. Eh. So, yon, greater than or equal to 2. So, therefore, it's always 0. But the question is, how about ang mga inverses? So, una, sa first one dito, can you tell me what's the inverse of 0?
So, kung 0 plus, ano, dapat maging 0 na po. 0, yun po yung ano.
So, how about 1? What's the inverse of 1?
1 plus 0 is still 1. So, kung 1 plus something should equal 0.
Therefore, in this case?
1. Para umabot.
Yes, it's still 1. So, kung isusulat natin dito, hindi ko na pala isusulat, you just simply look at this. So, ito, under this operation, sa nakikita mo, 0, the inverse of 0 is 0, the inverse of 1 is still 1. Titingnan mo lang yung diagonal mo dito. So, anything that creates 0, it's the inverse of the other number. How with this one? So, can you tell me the inverse of this number?
So, to get to 0, dapat 2 plus 1. Tapos, so 1 plus 2. 0, 0 lang po siya. So, 0 to 1, pabaliktad mo. Yung along the diagonal nga po. So, from yung inverse ko ng 0 is 0, inverse of 1 is 2, and then inverse of 2 is 1.
Correct.
Ah, ganda. So,
correct.
Inverse nga po ng...
How about this one?
Inverse ng 0 is 0. Inverse ng 1 by 2, 1 plus 2.
Okay.
Yes po. So, inverse
sorry,
ng...
Sorry, I think...
is also 0 nga. Wait lang po. So, 2 plus 2 dapat. So, wait lang po. B4 na. So, 2 plus 2 modulo 4 is 0. Hindi ba 2? Modulo ano po na? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Pag 4 na siya. 0, 1. One, three, two. Dapat zero. Ito pong plus four, plus ano po, plus sub four. Modulo four po siya. Di ba po? So, para umabot sa zero, the two you should add two to get four, and then that will become zero modulo four. Wala po kayo sound.
Sorry, nawala kasi ako. So kaya na turn off yung na-mute siya. So what are we're talking about? You're talking about yung mga it's ang importante lang the sum is equal to the modulo, to the number.
Tama.
Ayun. So in this case parang kung isusulat natin ito. So, what you're looking at, ang inverses mo, are these numbers paired together, its result are the identity element or the identity element which is equal to 0. So, pero at this time, I want you to observe for 5.
Naputil po.
Namabutil
po. Naputil po.
Choppy po.
Is equal to 5. So Z5. Okay na ba? Sorry.
Opo, okay na po.
Okay na po.
Ayun. Ginawa ko, nilagay ko lang yung cellphone ko sa bintana para at least medyo mabilis-bilis. So anyway, Sa, kung sa school ako medyo mabilis doon eh, okay naman doon. Pero dito sa bahay, sometimes nagkakaproblema. So anyway, so Z5 tayo ngayon. So I want you to observe later. Okay, 5-5 tayo ha. Tayo lang. Ilan to? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ito, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This will be 5. Ano mga call natin dito?
Ano ba? 0. Sa ano ba? First row is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Sa second row
Hello,
is...
Joshua?
Ano ba?
Oh, yes. Next.
Ano ba? Second row is 1, 2, 3, 4, 0.
Okay. 3, 4, 0. Next. Madali lang siya, di ba?
4, 0, 1. Tapos saan, ano
okay,
ba?
2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, and finally,
0, 1, 2,
4, 0. Okay, so maganda lang pattern niya. Ayan. Okay, so now, can you identify the inverses?
For 1, it will be 4. Yes. For 2, it will be 3.
Mm-mm.
For 3, it will be 2. And then for 4, it will become 1.
Mm-hmm.
Yung po. Tsaka zero is a...
Mm-hmm. Alright. So, so ito na. Yung mga, ano natin, examples natin.
Tabo.
4. All natural number n greater than or equal to your zn under this operation is a group. Okay, so group yan palagi. So my question, by the way, di ko pala na-emphasize kanina sa mga examples natin. Kanina above, ang mga na-identify na groups, are all of these groups abelian groups?
So for the real number positive, yes. Lahat po ng
positive. For example, this one, abelian ba to?
Lahat po ng plus po, yes. Tsaka, ano po? Ano ba? Yung...
Yes. Lahat ng plus. How about multiplication?
Yun din po. Lahat po ng yung multiplication. Commutative din po siya. So, abelian din po.
How about this one? Moto, multiplication.
San mo? May baka med para medyo na po kayo, para medyo delayed.
Well, a group an abelian group.
Wala.
Wala. Hello po, sir.
Hello.
Hello, Joshua. Hello.
Okay na po.
Ayun, sorry, napuputol ako ngayon.
Okay po.
Okay, so anyway. So, lahat ng mga examples natin kanina, all of these groups, so tanong ko, the last question I've asked you was, are all of these abelian? So for the answer is yes. So lahat ng mga na-identify natin mga groups, all of these are indeed abelian siya. So kasi we're only dealing with ordinary multiplication, ordinary addition, and for this type of groups, yung mga under modulo is as well abelian. So mga susunod nating groups, medyo iibahin na natin. So the first one, the first example we have, all of these is their number one.
Opo.
I'm sorry.
Hello po.
Hello.
Hello
po.
Po. Nadidinig niyo po kami, sir.
Anyway, sige. So, again.
Ano ba? Ayun. Para may days, ba? Diba? May ba ng, ano, may hours, eh.
Ah, kasi, ano, tapos ang work, ano sila? Facebook, mga ano.
Nagana na yung PLDT. Nagana sila. Ano ka ba? Kaya nga, iba-iba ba ang tao na di? Kung nakahanggan ka ba sa shallow water, nakahanggan ka ba rin nakahiga? Ano? Ayun, nakaano na. Enjoy that sa ibang anong device.
Hello, Joshua.
Hello po.
Apo.
I'll try po to ano, I'll try to connect sa ano ko sa ano to sa may cellphone. Feeling ko mas okay yung cellphone eh.
Okay po.
Mas okay nga
try ko lang po mag-connect muna.
Opo.
Peak hour po eh no.
Maybe break lang tayo mga around break tayo mga 5 to 10 minutes
okay,
muna.
Okay po.
So, try to connect sa ano ko. Thank you. So you can start the recording again. All right. So let's consider this set. Ang set natin may apat ka lang element. So I is the usual imaginary number or just the square root of negative 1. So sa ngayon, gagawa tayo ng Cayley table for this set. So in this case, ang multiplication natin dito is just the ordinary multiplication. And let's align the following numbers. 1, negative 1, and you have I, and you have negative I. And again, this is 1, negative 1, I, and negative I. So can you now fill this table with the elements? And then let's try to look at if all of the elements are still found in the set that we have defined. In this case, we have 1, negative 1, I, and negative I. So of course, let's start with 1 multiplied to the numbers. So you will have
1, negative 1, I, negative I more.
Ayan, 1, negative 1, I, and negative I. All right.
Tapos on the next
okay,
one.
Next. So you'll have?
Negative 1, 1, negative I.
And I. Okay, how about the third row?
I, negative I, negative 1, 1.
So you'll have negative 1 and 1. Okay. Then finally, you will have?
This is negative I, 1, negative 1.
Okay, negative I, you have I, you have 1, and you will have negative 1. Okay. So now, the question is, what are the inverses of these numbers?
Nawala po yung screen share na po.
Okay, ulit po. I'll just again screen share. Ayan. All right. So, my question, what are the inverses? So, anong inverse ng 1? Anong inverse ng negative 1? Anong inverse ng I mo? At anong inverse ng negative I?
So, 1 is definitely inverse na is 1. Negative 1, inverse niya is negative 1. I is negative.
Okay.
I. And then negative I is I po.
Okay, tama. So now in this case, can you say ba this is as well a group?
Meron po siya lahat po sila may inverse na yun. Meron din silang multiplicative identity. Meron din sila, associative ba po sila? Yes. Yung ano niya, binary operation. One, lahat po nandun. Yes, group po siya.
Correct. So, lahat-lahat ito are groups. So there are, sorry. This is also a group. So, now next, third example tayo. Sorry, I'm having difficulty talaga sa internet ko ngayon. So, please just bear with me. Anyway, you can... I think the Zoom recording later would be seamless, hopefully. So let's have the third one. Ito medyo a bit higher na siya because we will be introducing the matrix. But before I'll start with the matrix, can you tell me a bit of your background so far? Ano na yung alam mo with linear algebra and the matrices?
So meron po yung mga ano po tawag doon, yung basic operations, multiplying the matrices and then adding them. Meron din po yung tawag doon, yung mga arranging them into echelon form, yung mga row reduced echelon form. Sa meron din po alam sa mga basis at mga spans and things. Mga yun po.
Okay, that's good. Okay. So now, gagawin natin, what if we consider a collection of matrices? So let me write this here. Let's consider the collection of 2x2 matrices whose entries are real numbers. So ito yun, ang collection natin. Meaning, 2x2 matrix ito, and let's call the entries to be A, B, C, and D, such that A, B, C, and D are real numbers. So ito yung magiging symbol natin for the collection of 2x2 matrices whose entries are real numbers. So now, so the question is, under matrix addition muna tayo, is this a group?
Wait, so binary operation, any elements sa loob, they will just add anyway. So it must be true, it must be closed yung ano po yung addition under.
Okay, correct. So let's consider that closure muna. So let's consider the closure, meaning is this a binary operation? So let's consider two matrices. So A sub 1, B sub 1, C sub 1, and D sub 1. And let's consider another matrix, say A sub 2, B sub 2, C sub 2, and D sub 2. These two matrices are actually in a 2x2 matrix, real entries. Then add them together. So matrix addition, it's simply component-wise. So nag-a-add ka lang ng bawat component respectively. So you will have the following. So the first component, A sub 1, then B sub 1. A sub 1, B sub 1, mali. A sub 2. Tapos second component, B sub 1 plus B sub 2. Third component, C sub 1 plus C sub 2. And then the fourth component, D sub 1 and D sub 2. So lahat-lahat ng mga entries are real numbers. So therefore, this matrix is as well a 2x2 matrix whose entries are real number. So therefore, it is closed. How about the other properties na we have to check? So there are three. First, let's start with associativity. Is the matrix addition associative?
I think so. Yes, well, it must be true. Kung in the end po magiging A1 plus A2 plus A3, blah, blah, blah po. It must be...
Okay, so can you prove it? I mean, basic proof niya na indeed it is associative.
So kung ano nga po, A1 plus A2... So, tapos plus A3, lahat po, every single element, ganun po. In the end, may ging A1 plus A2 plus A3. So yung sa kabila rin po, kung A2 plus A3 yung nauna, tapos na-add rin po sa A1, the first, yung ano, top left element would be A1 plus A2 plus A3 pa rin po sa, pag nag-sambo sila. So, for the other, ano po, other members din po ng matrix
din po. Okay. Thank you, Joshua. So far, ang reception mo sa akin, because of my poor internet connectivity pa, paputol-putol siya, but I get what you are saying. So what you're saying that component-wise, since you are dealing with ordinary addition for each entries, so automatic na yon, associative. So, i-carry over niya yung component-wise addition doon to the bigger set of matrix na magiging associative siya. So, I think that's the statement that you are telling me right now. So, therefore, it is indeed associative. So, lalagay ko na lang dito, mag-check na lang ako that saying it's yes, associative. Now, next, how about the identity element? Ano ang magiging additive identity mo in terms of a matrix?
0, 0, 0, 0 mo.
Correct. So, you will have 0, 0, 0, 0. This is still a 2x2 matrix whose entries are real number. Since you have 0, 0, 0, 0 to be a real number. How about the inverse for each?
Negative po sila lahat.
Mga inverses mo.
Inverse po. Every single element is an inverse lang.
Yes. For... Correct. So therefore, for each of the matrix A, B, C, and D, yung matrix na tatawagin natin. So let me call this, if this is matrix A, so let's call this to be your matrix B, such that it na ang sum nilang dalawa, A plus B or B plus A, must be the zero matrix. So the only matrix na posibleng gagawin ito, if your matrix B is just the inverse or the additive inverse of A, or we can rewrite this as the negative of A, B, C, D. But we know this is just scalar multiplication ng negative mo. So you can rewrite this as negative A, negative B, negative C, and negative D. So you are correct. So tama. So therefore, okay, ito. So madali siya to say that indeed, this is A groups. Yes?
Tabo.
The set of 2x2 matrix whose entries are real numbers under addition is a group. Ah, so not question pala. Not question. So a group. Now next, oh, mag-shift tayo. Mag-shift na tayo ngayon. How about, iibahin natin ang matrix natin under multiplication. Ayon. So the question, is this a group?
So associative, I think so. I think I proved it already po sometime. Pero muna po yan. So yung, ano na, yung
naalala, let me recall muna. Ano ba yung matrix multiplication for 2x2 matrices? Say for example, susulat ko dito muna, Joshua.
Okay po.
So let's consider, say, a matrix A mo, say, A sub 1, matrix A sub 1 mo, ang laman is A sub 1, B sub 1, C sub 1. Sorry, naputol ako ulit.
Okay na po.
Hello?
Hello po.
Okay, sorry. Naputol ako ulit. So, let's consider these two matrices, A sub 1 and A sub 2. Ito yung mga laman niya, as you can see now on your screen. So, the question, what's the product of these two? Kung naalala mong matrix multiplication mo.
Ano po siya na, horizontal times the vertical yata po. So, each row. So, A1, B1. Tapos, sometimes, A2, C2. So, first is A1, C1 times A2. So, ano yan? A1 C A2 C1 plus next is B2, so B2 C1. D2, D2. Wala mo, hindi yata po ganun eh. Kasi, ikaw na ba? 2, 2. 2, 3, 4. Tapos on. 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 times 4. Ayun. So, ano siya na? 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 times 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Plus that. So, yung
I'm sorry, Joshua. Medyo putol-putol on my end. So I don't know if you're done explaining to me the matrix multiplication.
Tama. So, yung first sa top left, ano ba? Top left is A1 times A2 plus B
okay.
C1. B2 times C1 mo.
Times
B2 times C1 mo.
C2. Okay, correct. Okay.
Yun. Tapos on, next is...
I'm not sure kung tapos ka na, pero let me finish this on my end.
Hindi ko masusulat. Hindi siya magami.
So isusulat ko on my end. So you'll have C1 times A1 plus C1 plus A, C1, time, sorry. Delete ko lang muna to. So you'll have C1 times A2 plus D1 times C2. So the third entry, so you will have A1 times B2 plus B1 times D2. And then finally, you will have C1 times B2 plus D1 times D2. I don't know kung... were you able to explain it to me?
I think so, Bo. Hindi ko po alam. Hindi ko na alam po. Hello, Bo?
Hello, hello?
Ayan, rinig mo.
Okay. I'm sorry. I think... Ito na lang... Joshua, I think I'm having really difficulty right now with my internet connection. Maybe I make this up to you na kung andun na ako sa office by next week, doon na lang tayo, can we continue our discussion next meeting na lang?
Okay mo.
Kasi I'm having difficulty with my internet connection. I was not in the office earlier kasi for today. Because I have a seminar on one of the hotels dito. So, dumiretso ako dito sa bahay. So, I'm really sorry na hindi magandang internet connection ko. So, what we will do na lang is to have parang a make-up class on, let me say, let's continue pa rin na regular session natin on Thursday. Pero if you are available on... Since it's holiday pa lang 9, no? Hindi ko alam kung maganda pa rin yung internet connection, but I'll try this. We'll have this on a hotel, hotel. I'll stay in a coffee shop kasi mas maganda yung internet connection doon. Doon na lang ako magdi-discuss sa iyo. So, can we have a meeting on April 9? Will you be free? Same time, 5 o'clock in the afternoon?
Okay po.
So kahit i-cover na lang natin ang hindi natin natapos today on April 9 so that aabot tayo by April 11 to be our regular schedule. So makaka-cover kung additional topics herein.
Mabo.
So yun na lang. ang magiging setup na lang natin. So again, I'm really sorry kasi pangit talaga internet connection ko ngayon. So okay, I'll just see you na lang next meeting on April 9.
Okay po. Thank you po.
Thank you po.
Okay, thank you, thank you. Thank okay, you. I'll just send this copy sa lahat. Tatapusin ko lang to, yung write-up ko dito, or maybe they'll just continue. Sisend ko na lang to sa iyo ngayon. Thank you, okay. Joshua.
Thank you po, sir.
Oh, wait, last question
thank
lang
you,
po.
Thank you, sir.
Last question lang po. PDF mo po yung papadala na po or PNG po para alam ko po siya yung format.
Again, Joshua, what's your question?
PDF mo po yung papadala na po or PNG po?
PDF.
Okay po. Thank you po.
Thank you po,
okay,
sir.
Okay, sige. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you po. Bye-bye po. Thank you po.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Oh, bye-bye po, sir.
Bye.
Bye po.